Hi guys, right now I'm going to be presenting the regions of the body, right? So again, I have said before we have to be really fluent and have the proper skill to know all the medical terms, all of these we have to know. And then when we are communicating with our client, that we are communicating with them with layman's term. Okay, so I hope that we have established that. That is the one goal of a therapist, is to know that. Okay, so now for the regions of the body. So we have the facial area. I hope you can see. Yep, so the facial area will be around the face. That is very, most of these are self-explanatory. So the mandibular, because of the mandible. So that's when they say mandibular area, right? And then the clavicular, sorry about that. And supra meaning is on top or a little proximal, if you see, or superior to the clavicle, right? That is very self-explanatory. Is superior, supra meaning is su superior to the clavicle, right? And pectoral region is where the chest region is. Axillary is usually that fold, the axillary fold. And a little proximal, a little, I mean, distal, that is the region for the axillary. Brachial will be, where your biceps, usually when you're referring to a brachial. Cubital is, we all know, is at that area here, sorry. Right? And then abdominal, that is very popular, common, that we always here, especially women, right? So that's not really uncommon. And then the cubital and the inguinal, right? Here, it's re really common for guys to have a inguinal hernia, and this is usually where it occurs. Okay, they're more prone for inguinal hernia. I mean, I'm not gonna go into detail with that. So these are the pubic, right? So we're not gonna say we can refer to the pubic region, pubic area, because we're not specific, right? And especially we don't have any access to that region, so we will just refer to the pubic region. And femoral region, right? The femoral nerve runs there. And palmar. Okay, so palmar, so because this is dorsal, right? And this is palmar. This contains a lot of palmar aponeurosis, and it's really, really the strong. That's why a lot of people, instead of putting your shoulder backpack here, because there's that nerves here, veins, and a bundle, the brachial plexus, there's a bundle. So if you are wearing heavy backpack or bag, shoulder bag, it's going to compress on that. Whereas if you're holding it with your palm, it's better. Women are tend to use backpack or shoulder. Use your palm because this is very strong. This I'm even poking my the tip, right? Again, this is depend on the pain threshold. But having said that, this is a strong region of your for you to carry your necessities. Women are like they carry their, I don't know, half of their world in their bag, right? So if you want to do that, use your palm. That's all I'm saying. So let's go to the patellar. Okay, so the patellar, because of the patella, so that it became that region, patella. And crural is sometimes it gets get confusing for students. I had to admit when I was a student that gave me confusion, that word crural, because I said, oh, is it the caudal, right? I thought it was pertaining to the tail. So crural is the lower, and dorsal is at the tip of your foot. Plantar is at the bottom. Plantar, the underside of the foot, have also a lot of aponeurosis. Okay, so just keep that in mind. So the next video, I'm going to be doing planes of movement.